Mom, I'm doing a TFB TV video. Mom, yes, yes, Mom. Right now, I am filming a TFB TV video. Yes, I'll be home for dinner. Okay, yeah, I'll pick up a salami on the way home. Okay, I love you. I love you too, Mom. I'm sorry for you. I love you. Bye. Just kidding. This isn't a cell phone. It's a gun. Guys, it's James again with TFB TV. I posted this video on Instagram a few days ago, and people went nuts. I think it got like 200,000 views in the first 24 hours. The reaction was insane. You have people saying, wow, that's the coolest thing I've ever seen. You have people saying, that's the dumbest thing I've ever seen. You have people saying, wow, that's the dumbest thing I've ever seen, but also the coolest thing I've ever seen. You even have people saying that this device is a conspiracy to give police justification to shoot people while they're holding their cell phones. Well, regardless of which camp you fall in, you can't deny that this is pretty clever and pretty innovative. So what is this? This is a 380 Derringer. No more, no less. Just like the old Steamboat River Gambler Derringer, this is the exact same thing, just a more modern concept, and it just also happens to look like a cell phone. I mean, really, you could carry this just about anywhere, and nobody would be the wiser unless they'd seen this device before. It also kind of looks like maybe a battery pack or a brick for a charger. That means you've got two barrels and you've got one shot of 380 in each. This is not an auto loader. You've got two shots. You better make them count. This gun fires two shots alternating, so not both at the same time. Folding it out, it's pretty easy, and that looks pretty cool too. And you can see here the grip is basically a piece of sheet metal, but it's actually fairly comfortable whenever you shoot. I would suggest, while we're on the subject of grip, that when you shoot this thing, I wouldn't ride it too high. I noticed that I kind of got popped if I rode it too close to kind of the receiver portion. If you stay down on the grip, it's actually fairly comfortable to shoot. When you want to put the grip back in, you have these detents on either side. You depress both and rotate it back in, but it positively locks into place. Now, this is actually kind of ingenious. You see here, this is the contraption to open the action, and it also doubles as a rear sight. It's grooved, so that's your rear sight. And then you've got a little notch here, a subtle notch, as a front sight. I'm glad they have them on here, but I very seriously doubt anybody who actually uses this in a real life scenario is going to be aiming. This is going to be probably for very close and very uncomfortable encounters. But the sights are a welcome addition. You see, you open it up, you load your two rounds of 380 into the barrels, and you'll notice right here you have an ejector mechanism that allows you to expel the spent casings. Now, one thing I noticed when I was shooting it, you really need to apply pressure to this extractor while you're pressing it up if you want it to hook under those casings. If you just merely push it up and you're applying only upward pressure, it won't catch the rims on the casings and the casings won't come out of the gun. Alternatively, you could turn and give it a little bit of a shake and they might fall out. But guys, we're talking about a last ditch device here, so you're going to want to hope that your encounter's over after you fire the two rounds in here. In other words, you're not going to be speed reloading. Again, you have two shots, make them count. Now, speaking about that, in terms of accuracy, in terms of firing, the trigger is pretty heavy. I didn't take a trigger gauge to it, but it feels like about 12 to 15 pounds. It's not light, but I wouldn't call it a bad trigger, just really heavy. But remember, we're also talking about basically a double action gun. Hear that? And that's what's kind of neat, is because this is a double action gun. If you have, say, a light primer, you only have two rounds in there, you want to make sure that they both go off. So this allows you to keep mashing that trigger to make sure that those rounds, both of them, go off. Accuracy was fine, I guess about as good as any other double action only 380. You could hit a man-sized target very easily within the X at 7 yards. So this would work for its intended purpose in terms of accuracy. But comparing this to other 380 offerings on the market, I compared this to my car 380, and this device feels like it's heavier and feels certainly larger. Even when it's closed up like this, the car might be a little bit taller, but once you deploy the grip, it's actually substantially larger than my 380, but my 380 holds 7 rounds of 380 and it allows me to reload quickly. But that said, it's not really an apples to apples comparison. This is a device made for a specific purpose. You have people who are going to be looking for something like this that's clandestine, that's low profile, that gives them 2 rounds of 380. the people that buy this gun know what they're getting into. It isn't as if they're thinking about, hey, should I get a Kel-Tec P380 or the Carr 380, or should I get this Derringer 380? Speaking about the Ideal Conceal itself, it's pretty well made. It looks robustly constructed, it looks clean, and it works the way it's supposed to work. So I guess if you're looking for this kind of device, then I would say go for it. Go check one out, or I mean, honestly, you could probably just buy it if you like what you heard in this review. Now, would I carry this? I think hypothetically I could concoct a situation where it would be nice to have a device that looks like a cell phone or a battery pack that you can have in plain view. I could probably think of something like that, but for the most part, it isn't like I'm going to set aside my Carr 380 or my Glock 42 or my Kel-Tec. I think they probably could have made this a little bit smaller and a little bit lighter, but what do I know? I'm not an engineer. Maybe there will be a smaller, lighter version in the future, but as is, it is already pretty tiny. I think the materials that I read said that this was the size of a Galaxy S7 in a case. That's pretty small. Guys, I gotta run. Remember, groceries for mom from the store on the way home. But I wanna say thank you to you guys for watching. Thank you to Ideal Conceal for sending this. Thank you to the best sponsors in the world, Blue Alpha Gear. They make fantastic belts. And I shot ammunition that I got from Ventura Munitions, my dogs, through the Ideal Conceal 380. I hope everyone enjoyed this video. Stay safe. I will see you next week.